Hello, I'm Francesc Sallà, and I will guide you through this step-by-step video tutorial where you will learn everything you need to know about VisualARQ for developing a project of architecture inside Rhino. I would like to start by taking an overview of VisualARQ toolbars and interface. So first of all, we have a set of architectural objects. They are all parametric and can be created from curves, points, or surfaces, depending on the object type. Then there are some other tools for editing visual objects, for example this that let us doing Boolean operations between solids and visual objects. We have some tools for flipping the direction of visual objects, splitting them by points or curves, or fillet objects. Then we have tools for generating the 2D documentation of the project. There are commands to insert annotations, spaces for calculating areas, schedule tables for listing the information of visual objects and the other geometry in the model, tags to display properties of objects, sections, opening elevations, and this couple of commands for generating 2D plan and section views respectively. There are also some commands for opening the level and section manager panels that let you work at different elevations and manage sections and levels. Finally, there are some other tools for updating visual objects, doing opening an array, creating new custom profiles that can be used for objects or for their components, a command for editing the object and the cell properties of a selection of objects. This one is a shortcut to the document properties for creating new custom parameters. And finally, some commands for selecting objects by type. All commands are also available from the drop-down menu or from the command line. You just need to type VA and you will see the list of VisualARQ commands. If you're using Rhino and VisualARQ in a different language than English, you can just find the English name by typing _ followed by VA.